Hi everyone, in this session I will say another method in the Laplace transformation, which is Laplace transformation of f of t. Laplace transform of f of t, which is multiplied by t power n. Okay, in previously we discussed about the Laplace transformation of e power at into f of t. In the previous session we discussed about Laplace transformation of e power at into f of t. So in previous method, product of the f of t is exponential term. Product of the f of t term is exponential term. Now in this method we are going to discuss about the Laplace transformation of a function which is multiplied by t power n. This is the method in this session. Okay, write the statement. Laplace transformation of t power n into f of t is equal to minus 1 whole power n into d power n by ds power n. Nothing but nth derivative with respect to s. Nth order derivative with respect to s of the function L of f of t. For n is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. N be a positive integer. N must be natural number. Okay, positive integer, nothing but natural number. Okay. If we denote Laplace transformation of f of t with the function of s, then the above statement becomes L of t power n into f of t is equal to minus 1 whole power n into d power n by ds power n of L of f of t is nothing but function of s. Already we discussed in the previous sessions, if we find out Laplace transformation of a function of t, the result should be in terms of s. That's why replace here L of f of t by f of s. You should take n derivatives of f of s with respect to s here, where n should be positive integer. N may be 1, n may be 2, otherwise 3, etc. Okay, this is the method today. Okay, I will say the problems. Find L of t into cos at. Find L of t into cos at. So clearly here we are observing that the given problem is in the form of t power n into f of t. So please see here, t power n into f of t. Okay, that's why we can use this new method. Okay, don't use first shifting theorem for this problem. Okay, if the inside function is in the form of e power at into f of t, product of the function f of t should be exponential term, then only we can use the first shifting theorem on Laplace transform. Okay, here we do not have the exponential term in the product. Okay, that's why it is in the form of t power into f of t, and use the new method. As usual, first let f of t. What is f of t here? Cos at. What is L of f of t? L of cos at. Okay. And it is a direct formula. What is L of cos at? S by s square plus a square. And you can put the name as f of s. Now write the corresponding formula. What is the corresponding formula? The given problem is in the form of L of t power f of t. That's why write the formula of L of t power n into f of t, which is equal to minus 1 whole power n into d power n by ds power n of f of s. Write the given problem here and compare with this formula. So that implies L of t into cos at. We are observing that we have t instead of t power n. That's why n value is 1. So minus 1 whole power 1 into d by ds of what is f of s? Previously we get the value of f of s, which is s by s square plus a square. So it is enough to find out the differentiation of this term with respect to s. So we are observing that this is in the form of u by v. What is the derivative of u by v? Division rule. Division whole square. First write division whole square. And derivative of the numerator. And don't do derivative for denominator. Write negative sign. Now this time u is similar term. And derivative for the denominator. This is the derivative of u by v. Apply this formula here. Because both numerator and denominator are has variable s, that's why. So that implies L of t into cos a t is equal to, already here in the outside we have minus 1 whole power. Minus 1 whole power 1 means only minus. Denominator whole square. S square plus a square whole square. Okay, division whole square. Now write the derivative for numerator. Differentiation of s with respect to s is 1. So 1 into v s square plus a square minus. Now u is the similar term here. Don't do derivative for numerator now. S is similar term. Derivative for the denominator is 2s plus 0. 2s plus 0. Differentiation of s square with respect to s is 2s. Okay, already we know that derivative of x square is 2x and the derivative of a constant term is 0. Here we are taking the derivative with respect to s. That's why s square is a constant term. That's why its derivative is 0. Now simplify the terms. Minus of 1 into s square. S square plus a square. S into 2s. 2s square. Whole by s square plus a square whole square. Now minus of a square, s square minus 2s square is minus s square whole by s square plus a square whole square. So simply take this negative sign to inside, minus into minus plus s square minus a square by s square plus a square whole square. This is the conclusion of the given problem. L of t cos a t is equal to s square minus a square by s square plus a square. Therefore, L of t into cos a t s square minus a square whole by s square plus a square whole square. This is very very important result. Okay, we may use this formula in many problems. Okay, so please remember this one as a formula. L of t cos a t, already we know that L of cos a t. So what is L of cos a t? Simply s by s square plus a square. In the similar way, you should by heart this one as a formula. L of t cos a t is equal to s square minus a square by s square plus a square whole square. Okay, next result. Find L of t sin a t. In the previous problem, we discussed about L of t cos a t. Now it is L of t sin a t. Okay, we are observing that here also the inside function is in the form of t power n into f of t. Okay, that's why we can use the second method. Okay. What is f of t? As usual, first take f of t. F of t is nothing but coefficient of t, which is sin a t. Find out Laplace transformation of f of t and put the name as f of s. L of sin a t is equal to a by s square plus a square. You can say this is f of x. Okay. So now write the related formula. What is the related formula here? Here given problem is in the form of t power n into f of x. That's why we know that L of t power n into f of t is equal to minus 1 whole power n into d power n by ds power n of f of s. Substitute the value of n from the given problem, which is, what is the given problem? L of t into sin a t. So here we have t instead of t power n. That's why n is equal to 1 also here. So minus 1 whole power 1 d by ds of f of s. What is f of s? A by s square plus a square. It is enough to find out the differentiation of this term now with respect to s. So that implies, please write in the below of this step, L of t into sin a t is equal to minus 1 whole power 1. Minus 1 whole power 1 is 1, minus 1. So minus of, we are observing that in the numerator we have constant. Okay, that's why the remaining term is in the form of 1 by x form. What is the derivative of 1 by x? Minus 1 by x square. Derivative of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. So you will get here minus a by s square plus a square whole square. Minus a by s square plus a square whole square. Into, write the internal derivative. You should write the internal derivative by using the chain rule in the differentiation, in the product. So differentiation of s square with respect to s is 2s. And derivative of a square is 0. Don't forget to write internal derivative for the denominator. It is mandatory. Don't forget. So, minus into minus plus a into 2s. 2as. A into 2s can be written as 2as minus minus plus s square plus a square whole square. So, this is the result. Okay. So, L of t sin a t. L of t sin a t is equal to 2as by s square plus a square whole square. So in future many times we can use this relation, L of t sin a t is equal to 2as and 2as whole by s square plus a square whole square. In the similar way, the previous result is L of t cos a t. L of t cos a t, don't forget this, both s square minus a square by s square plus a square whole square. Both are very very important formula. Okay. Find L of t whole into 2 cos 2t minus 3 sin 2t. Okay. We are observing that here also the given problem. Please look at the inside of the operator L. Okay. Please look at the inside of the Laplace transform operator. So the given problem is in the form of t power n into f of t. Don't use first shifting theorem for this problem. First shifting theorem is not applicable for this problem, because if given function is in the form of e power a t into f of t, then only first shifting theorem is applicable. We see here the given problem is in the form of t power n into f of t. So let f of t is equal to 2 cos 2t minus 3 sin 2t. Find out Laplace. So split the terms. 2 into L of cos 2t minus 3 into L of sin 2t. Okay. So what is the formula for L of cos at? For the first part is in the form of L of cos at. Second part is in the form of L of sin at. So L of cos at is s by s square plus a square. That's why you will get 2s by s square plus 2 square 4 minus 3 into 2 by s square plus 4. Because already we know that L of sin at is equal to a by s square plus a square. So what is a here? 2. That's why. Now club the terms, because both terms are have similar similar denominators. So take the LCM, which is s square plus 4. 2s minus 3 2s are 6. And you can put the name as f of s. Now write the related formula. What is the related formula? We know that L of t power n into f of t is equal to minus 1 whole power n into d power n by ds power n of f of s. So substitute the value of n from the given problem. So that implies L of given problem is this one. T into 2 cos 2t minus 3 sin 2t is equal to, here we are observing that n is equal to 1. So minus 1 whole power n into d power n by ds power n of f of s. F of s means, sorry, already n is 1. So substitute n is equal to 1 in this formula directly. So minus 1 whole power 1 d by ds of f of s. What is f of s? This one. 2s minus 6 by s square plus 4. So you should apply division rule here also. U by v rule. So minus 1 is there in the outside. Open the bracket and write the derivative for inside term by using u by v rule. Denominator whole square. Okay. And the derivative for the numerator is simply 2. 2 into s square plus 4 minus. Numerator is same now. 2s minus 6 into. Derivative for denominator is 2s. For Laplace transformations also, knowledge of differentiation and knowledge of integration is very, very important. Without differentiation and integration, you can't cross the BTEC course. Okay. Very, very important. Okay. From intermediate level onwards, you should gain the knowledge on differentiation and integration, which is very, very important. Don't worry. Okay. So, simplify the numerator. S square plus 4 is whole square is the denominator. Take this 2 to inside. Minus is there. 2s square. 2 4s are 8. Minus 2s into 2s. 4s square. Minus into minus. Plus 6 2s is 12s. Okay. Minus of. What is 2s square minus 4s square? Minus 2s square. Okay. Plus 12s. Plus 8. Whole by s square plus 4 whole square. It is better to write one more step. Take this negative sign to inside. Minus minus plus 2s square minus 12s minus 8. Whole by s square plus 4 whole square. Okay. If you do not have the knowledge on the differentiation, in the next session I will give the another trick to find Laplace transformation of the similar problem. Okay, I will give another trick also to you, because some of the students still does not gain the knowledge on the differentiation and integration. That's why I will give the another trick also. Thank you very much. See you to next session.